Alright, thank you for staying with us, and it's time for us to move on to Australia, Melbourne. That's where Australia Open is taking place, and we have the man who's been keeping track of all the events, staying up to watch, analyze all the games. Semi Adebayo with us on the program tonight. Serena survived a scare earlier on.
Yeah, champion stuff. A lot of
she's the favorite to win now.
Yeah, especially with the world number one. Angelique Kerber out of it.
Maracova out.
It's been a tournament of surprises. Britain's Joanna Konta has been responsible for Makarova's exit. She's been responsible for Caroline Wozniacki's exit. And so you have a lot of interesting matchups. Let's go and talk about the women. Venus Williams, a lot of people didn't expect that, but she's there in the quarterfinal. She's going to be playing Anastasia Pavlyuchenkova in one of the quarterfinals. Serena Williams will play British Joanna Konta. That's going to be interesting to watch. I've been particularly surprised with the way Britain has been able to carry herself, especially with what has happened to Andy Murray for the guys. Coco Van der Weer and Gabriel Muguruza. Gabriel Muguruza has a Grand Slam to her name, but Coco Van der Weer is responsible for Angelique Kerber's ouster. So that also will be interesting. Then we'll see Karolina Pliskova also in the last quarterfinal. But for the guys, you know, you have the most experienced guys still on. Rafael Nadal and Roger Federer, between them, they have 31 Grand Slams. Then that's experience. But also another quarterfinal game to look forward to. Stanislas Wawrinka and Joe Wilfred Tsonga in the quarterfinal. Those two guys will play. Nadal edged past Gael Monfils.
Roger Federer, a tough game.
Yes, Roger Federer hedged past Kai Nishikori and Grigor Dimitrov defeated the guy who defeated Novak Djokovic. That's talking of Dennis Istomin. So Stanislas plays Tsonga, Roger Federer plays Zverev, and of course Nadal plays hard hitting Milos Raonic. So it's going to be interesting all the way for the ladies. Kind of have a feeling that we're going to see a new name on the Grand Slam, but for the guys, either Rafa or Roger Federer will be my pick.
Okay, I'm told our time is running out, so let me just spend some time to read a few of your comments. Hilary Indimele says the level of football artistry at the AFCON has really been quite commendable. I hope the tempo will be sustained. Mr. Legzi at favored Legzi says another disastrous officiating. That was not a penalty. The referee had a good view. Referees are messing up our league. Of course, the LMC have asked that referee be withdrawn, and they've also fined Abia Warriors for shoving the referee. Joe Baba Logistics says he's happy ABS of Ilorin, MFM of Lagos, Ifeanyi Oba are privately owned clubs in the league, and he hopes to see a lot more of these privately owned clubs in at the top flight. All right. A lot of comments about the AFCON. I'm told I have to close now, but the games are over. Algeria are out, Zimbabwe are out, Tunisia have finished second in that group. That's our show this Monday. Thank you for watching. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye now.